Thank you, Nicole. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and most welcome guests. And it is my chance to introduce myself to you. Instead of going through a list of things that I like to do or the food I like to eat, I want to tell you a little story about myself and how I achieved one of my childhood dreams. During the first year of my university, I came across a book called The Last Lecture. It was written by Randy Posh, a professor at Carnegie Mellon University, who was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. Before he passed away, he delivered an inspirational speech on how he achieved all of his childhood dreams by overcoming some of the most challenging obstacles. So I read the book and thought to myself, what is that one thing that I always wanted to do when I was a kid? It was obvious. I always wanted to go to Germany and live like a German. You might think that's a really, really strange dream for this little Asian girl to have. But going to Germany had a different kind of meaning. Both my brother and I were born in a small place called Großgera in Germany. I can't tell you much about it. My mom was studying there, and I left my birthplace after I was 2 years old. As I was growing up, I always encountered this question. So if you were born in Germany, what can you tell me about it? And I usually would just shrug and say, well, I don't know anything. I don't even speak the language. But as I was growing up, I kept on hearing stories from my mom. And she was telling me how much she loved the country and all her stories and everything. I started to have this growing desire inside of me to go to Germany one day and experience what is it like to be German. But I never found a true reason to return there until in 2010, I found this scholarship opportunity offered by the DAAD program for both science and engineering undergrad students. And I thought it was a really interesting opportunity for me because the projects were very appealing, and I was studying biotechnology during my undergrad years. So I thought if I gave it a shot, I could have a chance to live in Germany for 3 or 4 months. So I applied. Thanks. Unfortunately, I was overconfident, and I received this beautifully drafted letter of rejection. I can summarize the points for you. So the letter basically said, number one, there were way too many applicants and very little funding to distribute. Number two, a lot of these applicants actually came from an Ivy League school. I went to UBC, and I thought it was a good school. And number three, more importantly, my GPA was just not high enough to be in the top category. And I didn't have any practical experience. And of course, they added, my one-page application letter was just not convincing enough. So I thought, well, I might never have a chance to go there. I was just not qualified. But I didn't give up. In the following year, I wanted the opportunity even more. And the competition was even more difficult. So I knew I had to think outside of the box to make my application stand out. So guess what I did? First, I sent over 200 spam messages on Facebook to past scholarship recipients and asked them for advice. Did you know Facebook can actually block you for sending too many messages? So it happened to me. And I talked to so many people, I took little tips from them and applied them into my application. In addition, I was working really, really hard for my project at school, and I received one of those most outstanding reference letters from my supervisor. And at the same time, I spent countless hours writing and rewriting my application letter. And My friends, my family, and even internet strangers were helping me along the way. Finally, after 2 months, I submitted my application package. And for the next 2 months, I waited, waited, and waited. On March 14th, 2011, I received an answer. I was so nervous, I couldn't even open my email inbox. I felt like my heart was in my mouth. But I saw the word congratulations. It's hard for me to describe how exactly I felt at the moment, but for once in my life, I felt like I could really achieve something for myself. I ended up living in Berlin and traveling around Germany for 4 months. It was an incredible experience, and it was even better than I imagined. I went couch surfing on the weekends to meet up with locals and made long-lasting friendships. And I just felt like, in the end, the whole experience made me realize that sometimes we don't always get what we want. It's not because we're less fortunate or less qualified. It's because we don't want the valley enough. For me, my dream was to go to Germany. And after that first rejection, I could have given up. But instead, I tried everything I could to achieve that dream. And you know what? I'm really happy that I did. So thank you.